hundreds and hundreds of people come all around the Campbell River, Powell River area, wanting to speak, wanting to let people know their opinion. They weren't allowed to. The only person who was allowed to express an opinion was the CEO of Plutonic / General Electric. He could get up and talk about the virtues of it anytime he wanted to. So there we are. We've been totally without any kind of consequence, any consultation. I'm going to do things a little strangely now. I want to talk to you about the power needs of British Columbia, and I'm going to convince you, I hope, that it's utterly irrelevant. We have a couple of assessments that are going around. The government and the companies are telling everybody that we have imported power 7 of the last 10 years. What they don't tell you is that's just BC Hydro. They don't tell you about the power from Alcan and from Tech Cominco and from Fortis and so on. And if you go to the statistics of the National Energy, I'm sorry, I'm stumbling. I'm very, very tired today, so you're just going to have to bear with me. And you'll find that it's quite the opposite, that we export 8 years out of the last 10. And that, so you've got these two conflicting stories. But what I want to tell you is that it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter if we need lots of electricity. You cannot get it this way. God won't let you, because God doesn't let there be enough water except during the runoff in the spring and the couple of months thereafter. So it matters not whether we need energy. We can't possibly get it from that source. Our own BC Hydro reservoirs are full to brimming at that time of the year. So that leads you to the obvious conclusion that this is all going to be for export. And that's exactly what it is going to be. We're talking here about water for export. And in the one of the times that the president of Plutonic, Mr. McInnes, got a little cross, he sort of pounded the table and said, well, you'd have to be in a coma not to know that this is all for export. So that's what we're now in. And the government wants to talk about supplying power for British Columbia. This will not supply any power whatsoever to British Columbia. We have to have that firmly in mind. And if the day came that everybody was driving electric cars, we still couldn't get the power, this source. We'd have to find another source of the power. This is simply a part-time power rendition. That's it. That means that we meet for the first time the elephant in the room, called NAFTA, North American Free Trade Agreement. Under NAFTA, according to the experts we have, and I urge you to take a look at our website and read Wendy Holm, what she has to say about this, there are 3 very, very substantial dangers. The first one is that when an American company has the right to do anything with water in Canada, of course, in British Columbia, they can use it for any purpose, not just the purpose that they applied for. So presumably they could do it to export bottled water, water in bulk, you name it. That's what happens when NAFTA kicks in. The second thing that happens is that when it comes to the end of the tenure, the lease, or whatever it may be, the American company is still using the water, they can continue to use the water, never mind what the lease or the legislation says. And then, of course, I suppose the one that is the most difficult to sort of get a grasp on, but nevertheless is there, is what they call a proportionality clause, which means if we export power to the United States, we can never cut back that unless we cut back the same amount ourselves. So NAFTA puts us in an entirely different position. The reason that it does is that it's an international treaty. And as an international treaty, it trumps all local laws, federal, provincial, municipal, and all private agreements, public agreements. So this has not been talked about. There has been no consultation and absolutely no recitation of what the real problems are going to be. Now, incidentally, if you do get in the argument about do we or don't we need power, I can tell you this. We have absolutely no concerns about power for a very long time to come. With conservation, about which we do very little in this country, new generators on the dams we have, generators for the first time on dams that don't have generators, and everybody seems to forget on the government side about 10% of our requirements could come from the Columbia River downstream benefits. We now take money for that instead of power, and we're entitled to the power. But again, I say that that is irrelevant for this is a very busy place. That's irrelevant for the purposes of the discussion, but that's the answer. Probably one of the most serious consequences of all this is going to be the loss of BC Hydro. And BC Hydro is on its deathbed. And I'll tell you why in just a second. But you may remember that some of you are even as old as I am here. You'll remember W.A.C. Bennett with sort of his three-pronged attack. He wanted to be able to have the government and the people exercise policy in three distinct areas. One was with the ferries. He knew that a private company would not run a line, into a place unless it was profitable. They would not take a loss. So he bought the Blackball ferries, turned it into BC ferries, and used it as a tool of development as much as anything else. He took the old PGE railroad, made it into BC Rail, and did the same thing. He built spur lines where no one else would go because it wasn't profitable. When he wasn't doing that, it was very profitable indeed. But whatever money it was short, it went to the cause of bringing the rail to people who otherwise wouldn't get it. This really is an interesting place. Jingle bells. And of course, the last one is BC Hydro. And he, as you remember, he took over the BC Electric and the BC Power Commission, put them all into one, and got a power company so that the people would have the say as to how much power would be produced, where it would be delivered, and so on and so forth. And the government could use it as a tool of development by giving electricity rates, breaking electricity rates to some people if they did certain things. So he had these three tools that he used, and they were very, very successful. Now I'm going to tell you why BC Hydro is on its last legs. It must, under the present rules, present energy plan, it must pay all of these private companies, but must put them under contract, and is forced to do it at the price that he decides. That's Mr. Campbell. The classic one is $120 being paid per megawatt hour, for which BC Hydro would be lucky to sell it for $60. So the free market government we have, free enterprises and so on, have discovered a new business principle: buy high and sell low. And this is exactly what they're in. The BC Hydro at this point is stuck with $30 billion in these contracts, which will come to fruition within the next 20, 30 years. But that's just the surface. That's only the 35 or so that are going. You can imagine what this is going to be like when you get hundreds of these streams going, all being paid for by BC Hydro, all at a loss. BC Hydro has been forbidden to bring on stream any new power. They can use the grandfathered stuff, Site C, and they can repair their generators or put new generators in, but they can't get any new sort of source of power. That must be done in the private sector. BC Hydro will carry its usual $7 billion capital debt, which is not a big deal if it's left alone, but under these circumstances, it won't be able to handle it. So this means at the end of the day, BC Hydro is going to be broke. It's going to be broke in a very short time. And what this means is very important to us in a financial sense, never mind all the rest of it. BC Hydro, over the years, has paid huge dividends to the province of British Columbia. One time, nearly $1 billion. Last year, about $500 million. And that money goes into our hospitals and our schools and our roads and our social services and so on. That money isn't there anymore. Gone. Where is it gone? It's gone to the shareholders of General Electric, Ledcor, companies like that. Our money.